U.S. Olympic swimmer Jimmy Fiven has agreed to pay $11,000 to a Brazilian charity over his involvement in a false story about an armed robbery in Rio. He was one of four gold medalists, along with star Ryan Lochte, who hit the headlines after Mr. Lochte said the group had been robbed. CCTV footage later showed the story had been invented after the swimmers Bengalis a petrol station. Mr. Lochte left Brazil on Tuesday, but Mr. Fiven stayed behind and was detained. The two other members of the group, Gunnar Vence and Jack Conger, were pulled off a flight in Rio on Thursday night and questioned by police. They denied any involvement in the false robbery claim and were allowed to leave the U.S. on a later flight. Mr. Lochte initially said the four were robbed at gunpoint by men disguised as police officers while the athletes were returning from a nightclub by taxi. But police could not find any evidence of the crime, and Rio's civil police head Fernando Belloso ruled that the swimmers invented the story. No robbery was committed against these athletes. They were not victims of the crime, they claimed, Mr. Belloso said. He told reporters that one or more of the athletes had instead vandalized the toilet in a petrol station and then offered to pay for the damage. The Americans paid and left after armed security guards intervened, he said. One guard had justifiably drawn his gun after one of the swimmers began behaving erratically, Mr. Belloso added. He warned that the swimmers, who had repeatedly changed their accounts of what happened, could in theory face charges of giving false testimony and vandalism. But later on Thursday, the men's lawyer Sergio Rivera said Mr. Vence and Mr. Conger had been allowed to leave the country by a special Olympic court. He provided the revised statement this evening Thursday with the hope of securing the release of his passport as soon as possible, said the U.S. Olympic Committee USOC. The USOC statement confirmed the version of events given by Mr. Belloso, and added that the behavior of these athletes is not acceptable, nor does it represent the values of Team USA. How the story evolved Sunday, August 14. Ryan Lochte's mother tells U.S. media her son has been robbed in Rio de Janeiro. Mr. Lochte gave an account of the event, saying he, Gunnar Vence, Jack Conger and James Fiven were returning by taxi from a club in the early hours of the morning when they were robbed at gunpoint by men who forced the vehicle to pull over. The swimmers do not report the incident to police or to the U.S. Olympic Committee, and police officers only get involved after seeing TV reports Monday, August 15. Police investigating the case say there are inconsistencies. In the men's accounts Tuesday, August 16, CCTV footage emerges of the men's return to the athletes' village showing them laughing and joking, and handing over wallets and phones as they go through the security screens. Wednesday, August 17, Ryan Lochte admits there were inaccuracies in his original account of being robbed at gunpoint, but vehemently denied making the story of judge orders that the passports of the four men be seized. Before it emerges that Mr. Lochte has already left for the U.S., Gunnar Vence and Jack Conger taken off the outbound plane at Rio de Janeiro Airport Thursday, August 18. Brazilian police sources tell media outlets that the men invented a story about a robbery to disguise the dispute over a damaged bathroom door at a petrol station in Barra de Juca. 16 kilometers 10 miles from the Olympic Park. CCTV video emerges that appears to show the athletes being detained and ordered to sit on the ground. Gunnar Vence and Jack Conger enter a Rio police station for questioning. Head of Rio civil police emphatically denied the robbery took place, saying the case centered around an incident of vandalism and payment for damage. Gunnar Vence and Jack Conger fly out of Rio, with James Fiven unable to travel as his passport is still held by the Brazilian authorities.